Ladies and gentlemen, may I now invite our Honorable Home Minister Sri Rajnath Singh, and may I please request him to kindly make his opening remarks.
Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji, Honorable Deputy Prime Minister Mr. Felsuk, Republic of Mongolia, Honorable Deputy Prime Minister of Nepal Sri Bimalendra Nidhi ji, Mr. Toshisho Nipai, Secretary General LDP from Yaman, Mr. Robert Glaser, Special Representative UN Secretary General, my colleague ministers of state, Sri Hans Rajji Ahir and Sri Kiranji Riju, Home Secretary Government of India, Sri Rajiv Maharshi, esteemed colleagues on the dais, distinguished delegates from Asia and Asia Pacific countries, representatives of United Nations organizations, civil society organizations, representatives of local bodies from India, ladies and gentlemen. On the occasion of the 7th Asian Ministerial Conference on Disaster Risk Reduction, it gives me great pleasure to welcome you all to India. I am grateful to the ministers, distinguished delegates, and representatives of local self-governments who, despite their busy schedule, have accepted our invitation to participate in this event. The gathering today collectively represents commitment for a safe and secure world. I hope my ministry has made all possible efforts to make your stay comfortable here in New Delhi. I hope you all will have a pleasant stay here and that our visit will be fruitful and rewarding in terms of outcomes and learnings. Disasters, both natural and man-made, are occurring with increased frequency and intensity. The Asian region is especially vulnerable. 8 of the 10 disasters in the world occur in Asia, making 2/3 of the world's population vulnerable. We believe that disaster resilience is the collective responsibility of all segments of society, including governments, business community, non-governmental sectors, and individuals. If we all work together with a united focus and a shared sense of responsibility to improve disaster resilience, we will be far from effective than the individual efforts of any one sector. This is, therefore, a timely and important conference, a critical first step in implementing the Sendai framework in our region. Disasters seriously affect our economy, are a setback to our developmental efforts, and most of all, cause untold grief of the families who lose their near and dear ones. Moreover, a grieving family is simultaneously faced with the loss of home and livelihood. Minimizing the responsibility and then the impact of this human tragedy at its worst is, in my opinion, amongst the most critical part of the compact between the state and its citizens. It is gratifying to note that the agenda of the conference covers a wide diversity of subjects ranging from risk governance, making world heritage resilient, to business and private sector engagement in disaster risk reduction. I belong to and have been Chief Minister of a state that is threatened by both earthquakes and floods. I have witnessed firsthand the suffering that such disasters bring and am aware that our civilians, such as unregulated building, is adding to the already greater risk caused by factors such as climate change. It is therefore a matter of great satisfaction to me that our focus is shifting from disaster management to disaster risk reduction. There is now international acknowledgement that efforts to reduce disaster risk must be systematically integrated in policy, plans and programs for sustainable development and poverty reduction. We all know, of course, that disaster risk recognizes no political boundaries. This includes risks caused by human actions. Disasters in one region can and will impact other regions. It is therefore also satisfying that today we realize that both disaster risk reduction and disaster relief need to be supported through bilateral, regional and international cooperation, including partnership. It is with this spirit of regional and international cooperation that India has supported and is always ready to support other countries, especially its neighbors, in disaster mitigation and management efforts. We offer the best we have in terms of technology, capacity building, and relief expertise to all those in need. We are uncompromisingly committed to regional and international cooperation in this regard. In India, our ancestors gave us the concept of Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, which means that the whole planet with all its human beings, plants, animals, birds, and natural resources is one family. This ancient realization of our interconnectedness is even more relevant and urgent today. I would like to urge this August gathering to embrace this significant notion and hence enhance international cooperation through sharing of technology, expertise, and necessary resources. Here I would also like to reiterate the commitment made by our Honorable Prime Minister in SAARC Summit last year of ensuring India's help and expertise to its neighboring country. Ladies and gentlemen, there is a clear need to discuss specific aspects of multilateral dialogue and cooperation, such as establishment of clear channels of communication, sharing scientific knowledge, creation of a database of disaster response capabilities, and pre-positioning of material to shorten response time. Disasters in India are being handled at all levels, at the national, the state, and the district levels. Comprehensive and holistic policies for management of all disasters supported by plans, legal framework, and the financial arrangements are essential elements of any strategy for their management. The role of the states is crucial in this as they face the immediate brunt from disasters. We are, of course, committed to doing the utmost to support their endeavor. Ladies and gentlemen, India has taken up several initiatives to substantially reduce disaster risk and losses in life, livelihoods and health, and in the economic, physical, social, cultural and environmental assets of persons, business, communities and country. On the first day of June 2016, India and Asia's first ever national disaster management plan were released by our Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Modi. The plan outlines a framework for strengthening disaster risk governance at various levels. The plan also provides a framework for disaster risk reduction through mainstreaming disaster risk reduction into developmental plans. The AMCDRR is a unique opportunity to come together and provide a sense of urgency to the implementation of Sendai's framework. We have invited a number of officials from our local and state government who will have a lot to share with and learn from you. In the run-up to AMCDRR, a number of our educational and training institutions have organized curtain raiser events to broaden the engagement on disaster issues and mobilize the capacities of all sections of society. Before concluding, we pledge our support to Asian Regional Plan for implementation of the Sendai framework, its goals and priority. We commit ourselves to work with countries in the region to achieve the goals of Sendai framework towards a safer and resilient Asia and the world against disaster. I once again thank you all for your participation. Jai Hind.